Good morning. Great responsibility devolves upon leaders. What happens when they depart from God? Our reading's at Jeremiah chapter 13, verses 18 to 23 today. Say to the king and to the queen mother, humble yourselves, sit down, for your rule shall collapse the crown of your glory. The cities of the south shall be shut up, and no one shall open them. Judah shall be carried away captive, all of it. It shall be wholly carried away captive. Lift up your eyes and see those who come from the north. Where is the flock that was given to you, your beautiful sheep? What will you say when he punishes you? For you have taught them to be chieftains, to be head over you. Will not pangs seize you like a woman in labor? And if you say in your heart, why have these things come upon me? For the greatness of your iniquity, your skirts have been uncovered, your heels made bare. Can the Ethiopian change his skin or the leopard its spots? Then may you also do good who are accustomed to do evil. So the invasion has begun. The Babylonians are in the land. They're coming toward Jerusalem. The whole land's going to be emptied. Thousands are going to be carried away into captivity. God is punishing Judah for her sins. Now, the people are subject to the king, but also the king, in some measure, is subject to the people. When there's apostasy, there's almost always a lot of cowardice. A lot of cowardice among the people and a lot of cowardice among the leaders. People need to hold leaders accountable. But when the people themselves are in gross apostasy, it becomes very hard for the leaders also to address it the way that they'd like to address it. Now, some of the kings of Israel didn't really want to address it. So when the people themselves are in apostasy, the nation is headed for grave outcomes. And Judah's certainly headed for grave outcomes here. Can the Ethiopian change his skin or the leopard its spots? Then may also you do good who are accustomed to do evil. This is commonly cited basically when we're talking about sin and salvation. And people say, look, you're all sinners. You can't change. Then they say it based on this verse. But check the context. Check what's going on. God has tried. He sent his prophets over and over again to get Israel to repent. He wants the kingdom, the people in the kingdom of Judah to repent. So what this is saying here is basically you guys have decided who you're following. You've decided who you're going to serve. You've made up your mind to be in apostasy. You've not responded to my calls to you. It doesn't mean they can't change. In fact, they can change. It's the very opposite. They could have changed if they'd wanted to, but no, they didn't want to. So now they're going to reap the outcome of that. So no, the Ethiopian can't change its skin or the leopard its spots. But you know what? With God, all things are possible. And even people who are deeply involved in sin can turn to the King of Heaven if they're willing. Judah just isn't willing. The problem with the kingdom of Judah is they have refused to change. So they're set in their evil and punishment has been decreed and they're going to get it now. Leaders are accountable for the flock. On the judgment day, a terrible accounting is going to come for many of these apostate kings of Israel. And today, an awesome weight of responsibility rests upon Christian leaders in our time. Jesus taught that to whom much is given, much will be required. And we should be on our knees and on our faces before the Lord for his guidance in these remarkable times. Let's pray. Dear Father in heaven, we want to be right. We need your help. Please, Lord, help us to be praying people. Help us when leadership is wibbly-wobbly all around in the world, often in the church. Lord, help us to, again, look directly to you. Help us to take our marching orders from you, Lord, the King of Heaven, from your word, from the insight you give us. Help us to know what to do in these crazy times so that we're right, so that we're right with you. Please, Lord, guide us in these times. Thank you for hearing our prayer, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. So when leaders depart from God, the whole flock is jeopardized. Let's pray right now so that we'll know what to do when we sometimes are faced with erring leadership in various parts of our world. God be with you today. Walk with him.